What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. In our tree series, we discussed and implemented binary trees in depth. We also explained the difference between BSTs, AVL trees, red-black trees, and many other tree types. The link to the series can be found in the card above. Now, the reason I am telling you this is because today's problem revolves around one particular property that helped us distinguish between these tree types, and it is whether a tree is balanced or not. As a reminder, a tree is height balanced at its root if the difference in height between the roots right and left subtrees is not bigger than or equal to 1. So, to visualize this, take this tree as an example. The height of the null nodes is usually set to 0. Therefore, the node above it has a height of 1, the one above it a height of 2, and so on. To retrieve the height of a node with 2 children, we compare the heights of its left and right children, retrieve the maximum between them, and add 1 to it. If we keep applying this logic on all the nodes in the tree, we will obtain the respective heights of the right and left children of the root node. And if the difference between these heights is not bigger than 1, then this tree is said to be balanced at its root. Now, if we were to implement this logic as is, we would first check if the root node supplied is null, then simply return true. If not, then we must retrieve the difference in height between the left and right children of the root, and if their absolute difference is less than or equal to 1, then we return true. Okay, until now this looks good. What we still need to implement is this height method, which we did in many of our earlier videos. You see, we just mentioned that the height of any given node is the maximum between its left and right children heights plus 1. So here, if the node is a null node, then its height is 0, and if it isn't, then its height is the maximum between its children's heights plus 1. Okay, after implementing this method, we can now tell if a given binary tree is balanced at its root or not. Now, what if after solving this problem, the interviewer asks you to figure out if a given tree is balanced at each node and not only at its root? To visualize this, take this tree as an example. You can clearly see here that this tree is balanced at its root, as the difference in height between its left and right children is 1. But what about this node in red? The height of its left child is 2, whereas the height of its right child is 0, making it non-balanced. So how do we fix the logic we wrote earlier to match these new criteria? Well, that is the beauty of recursion. After checking if the tree is balanced at its root, we need to utilize the same logic on all the remaining nodes in the tree, right? And this is done by simply calling the same method we are making use of on the root's left and right children. That's it. Our method now checks every single node in the tree and only returns true if all of them are balanced. Okay, we just saw how with the help of recursion we can calculate the height of each node in a tree, and by now you should know that the height of the root represents the height of the tree as a whole, or in other terms, the maximum depth of that tree. However, the interviewer might not always be looking for that maximum depth or looking to check if a tree is balanced. Sometimes they might ask you to retrieve the minimum depth of a given binary tree, and that is the problem we will attempt to solve next. You see, in this example, the minimum depth of that tree is 2, because the shortest path from the root down to the nearest leaf node contains 2 nodes only, root node included. Now, some of you may already have an idea of how we are going to implement the solution to this problem, as while checking if a tree is balanced or not, we made use of the height method. And in this method, we were retrieving the maximum or longest path from the root down to the farthest leaf node. So, if we go ahead and replace the max function with the min one, and just rename the method if you want, we will obtain a valid implementation to the problem at hand. However, there is a catch. You see, if this method was provided with the tree we were previously making use of, it will work. It will return 2 as the minimum depth, and that is a correct answer. But what if this method was provided with that tree instead? It will return with a minimum depth of 1, even though the expected minimum depth here is 3, as the minimum depth is defined as the shortest path from the root down to the nearest leaf node and not null node. So when a node does not span a left branch, for example, and a 0 is returned, that 0 should not be taken into consideration if that same node spans a right branch. To include this corner case in our current implementation, all we need to do is check if either branch is returned with a 0 value. If that is the case, then slowly return with the result of the other branch plus 1, and if not, then and only then proceed by calling the minimum function we previously added. That's it! The links to the LeetCode problems we solved today can be found in the description below. Let me know your thoughts and suggestions for upcoming videos in the comments section. And that's it for today. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.